लाइफ हिस्ट्री एंड कंट्रीब्यूशंस ऑफ डॉक्टर जे टी केंट। डॉक्टर जेम्स टाइलर केंट, MD, 1849 to 1910। बर्थ। जेम्स टाइलर केंट वॉज बॉर्न ऑन March 31, 1849 इन वुडहल, न्यूयॉर्क, द सन ऑफ स्टीवन केंट एंड हिज वाइफ कैरोलिन टाइलर। एजुकेशन। केंट अटेंडेड सेकेंडरी स्कूल एट द फ्रैंकलिन एकेडमी ऑफ प्रैट्सबर्ग, न्यूयॉर्क, बिफोर इनरोलिंग एट मेडिसन यूनिवर्सिटी, टूडेज कोलगेट यूनिवर्सिटी, फ्रॉम विच ही वॉज ग्रेजुएटेड विद अ बैचलर्स डिग्री इन 1868। ही अर्नड अ मास्टर्स डिग्री फ्रॉम द सेम इंस्टीट्यूशन इन 1870। केंट अटेंडेड द इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ एक्लेक्टिक मेडिसिन एट सिनेसिनेटी, ओहियो, वेयर इन एडिशन टू स्टैंडर्ड मेडिसिन ही स्टडीड नेचुरोपैथी, होम्योपैथी एंड चिरोप्रैक्टिक। केंट ग्रेजुएटेड फ्रॉम द इंस्टीट्यूट इन 1873। कैरियर। इन 1874 केंट मैरिड इलेन एंड सेटल्ड इन सेंट लुइस, मिसूरी, वेयर ही टुक अप मेडिकल प्रैक्टिस। हिज वाइफ डाइड शॉर्टली आफ्टर मैरिज एट द एज ऑफ 19। ही सेट अप प्रैक्टिस एज एन इक्लेक्टिक फिजिशियन इन सेंट लुइस, मिसूरी एंड सून बिकेम अ डिस्टिंग्विश्ड मेंबर ऑफ द एक्लेक्टिक नेशनल मेडिकल एसोसिएशन। ही टुक अ पोस्ट एज अ प्रोफेसर ऑफ एनाटमी एट अमेरिकन कॉलेज इन सेंट लुइस 2 years लेटर। फ्रॉम एलेक्टिसिज्म टू होम्योपैथी। इन 1878 केंट्स सेकेंड वाइफ लूसी बिकेम इल। इन स्पाइट ऑफ लूसीज सिम्टम्स ऑफ नर्वस वीकनेस, इंसोमनिया एंड एनीमिया, बींग ट्रीटेड बाई बोथ ऑर्थोडॉक्स एंड इक्लेक्टिक फिजिशियंस, हर कंडीशन कंटिन्यूड टू डिटेरिएट एंड सी वॉज बेडरिडन फॉर मंथ्स। ऑन डॉक्टर केंट्स वाइफ्स रिक्वेस्ट, डॉक्टर रिचर्ड फेलिन, अ होम्योपैथिक फिजिशियन, वॉज कॉल्ड इन टू सी लूसी। फॉलोइंग हिज प्रेस्क्रिप्शन, सी मेड अ ड्रामेटिक रिकवरी। एज अ रिजल्ट केंट एलेक्टेड टू स्टडी विद फेलिन एंड चेंज फ्रॉम एक्लेक्टिज्म टू होम्योपैथी। Realize the power of potentization. Kent began practice with low potencies, but he was not satisfied. Later he resolved to test the 30th potency to see if there was any medicine present. He prepared with his own hands the 30th potency of podophyllum according to centesimal scale after the method of Honeyman. One day a child was brought in to his clinic in emergency, and it appeared that the child would not live long. While it lay in the arms of its mother, a thin yellow fecal stool ran all over his carpet. The odor was like that of the podophyllum stool. It was horribly offensive, and the stool was so copious that the mother made the remark that she did not know where it all came from. Dr. Kent thought to test podophyllum 30 prepared by him for that case. Next morning, he was surprised to learn from the grandmother of the child that he was doing well. One dose of podophyllum cured a dangerously ill patient. He then realized the power of potentized remedies, and he thought of using increasingly potentized remedies in his practice. High potency homeopath. He became famous as high potency homeopath, as most of the homeopaths before him were using low potency remedies. He advocated the use of 30th, 200th, 1m, 50m, cm, dm and mm potencies made on the centesimal scale. Dr. Kent introduced the doctrine of series in degrees in the treatment of chronic diseases. He found that one potency was not sufficient for chronic cases, though it would generally do for acute illnesses. Many chronic illnesses were cured by keeping the patient under the influence of one indicated remedy for 2 or more years. Series in degrees. Dr. Kent discovered that just as there are octaves of musical tones, so there are octaves in the simple substance, through which severally it is possible to correspond with the various planes of interior organism of the animal cells. These planes correspond to the similar remedy in 30th, 200th, 1m, 10m, 50m, cm, dm and mm potencies. He found that when the action of the 30th is completed, the patient needs the 200th potency. But when the action of 200th potency is exhausted, the patient requires the 1m potency, and so on till the same remedy in higher and the highest potencies cures permanently. law of vital action and reaction. Dr. Kent also discovered the law of vital action and reaction, as pointed out by Dr. Honeyman. A medicine is not too high to cure, so long as it is capable of aggravating the symptoms belonging to the sickness in the first hours in acute and in the first few days of a chronic sickness. He also thought that a homeopathic aggravation was essential from the application of Similimum in chronic cases. Dr. Kent felt that if there was relief without homeopathic aggravation, the chronic sickness was only superficially affected and would require a deeper acting remedy to remove the vital disorder. Will, understanding and memory. Dr. Kent laid greatest importance to will, understanding and memory of the patient. They form the innermost of the man and are extended outward through the general physical organism. Cure takes place from center to periphery, but if the symptoms retreat from periphery to center, the prescription is wrong and it must be antidoted. Hence, in order to treat successfully, the homeopath should know the correspondence of organs and direction of cure. Death. After completing third edition of repertory, on the insistence of his students, he took a vacation and went to Stevensville, Montana. He was suffering from catarrhal bronchitis, which developed into Bright's disease, and 2 weeks later, on June 16, 1916, he died. Contributions. Lectures on Homeopathic Philosophy. Repertory of Homeopathic Materia Medica. Lectures on Homeopathic Materia Medica. Lesser Writings, Clinical Cases, New Remedies, Aphorisms and Percepts. Use of the Repertory, How to Study the Repertory, Clinical Cases, Repertory and Repertorization. What the Physician Needs to Know in Order to Make a Successful Prescription. His life was gently and the elements so marked in him that the nature might stand up and say to all the world, this was a man. C.P. Thakkar. Thanks for watching. Like, comment the topics you want me to explain, share the video with your friends and subscribe the channel for more videos on homeopathy.